here in Seattle. Today, the third and final game in this three-game series between the Arizona Diamondbacks and the Seattle Mariners. With Dan Plesac and Mark DeRosa and D-Roll, a major league debut on tap in this one for a guy that comes pretty highly regarded as a prospect.
He does, Matty. I think there's several reasons to be excited about this kid and what he might do in his career at the big league level. I know his nerves have got to be running high right now, but no matter how he performs today, it should be fun to see how he develops and if he can establish himself as a solid big leaguer moving forward.
Number 8, a right-hander out of Tennessee, will be the starting pitcher. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
This guy has a three-pitch mix. He needs all three of his pitches.
Change it to the analog. For some reason, it's a broadcast view.
He has them all working and uses them properly. He has a chance to be very effective.
Fellas, the Mariners entering play here this afternoon. Coming looking to turn things around as they've dropped two straight.
Yeah, man, things haven't gone too well so far in this series. They're looking to avoid the sweep here in this one.
Yeah, they got to get off in the early innings. It's going to be monumental if they can push a few runs across and give this pitcher a chance to relax.
Strike call now with one out.
Well, he tried to turn a single into a double by stealing second on the first pitch, but they were ready for it. Good catch and throw from behind the plate. Hits like that base hit never happened.
Here comes the 0-1. Tried to shave the corner with that pitch, but it's 1-1. All right, temperature a very comfortable 72 degrees as we get things started. Good breaking ball there. Laid off for the second strike.
Hey, that's a great job by the pitcher right there. Stealing a strike with that getting the over breaking ball. And now he can get a little nastier with it.
Swing
and a liner. And that's the second out. Ready now is David Peralta. He's 3-7 in the series coming in. A swing and a drive to center field. That one's got a chance. And this one is gone. A home run.
This guy has been a serious thorn in the side of the staff. Homering twice in 3 days. The numbers don't lie. He owns these guys right now.
David Peralta.
At the plate now, Ketel Marte.
Already given up a home run.
Bouncer to the left side. Reined in. Throw on the first, gets him, and the side is retired. One run here. Stepping in, Nick Ahmed. He's been productive at the plate in the series with 6 hits coming into this one. Second inning starts with a fastball that misses. It's 1-0.
You bet. Retire the side.
Hit pretty well out toward right center field. Center fielder on the run. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. Eduardo Escobar comes on with one away as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0. That's wide, 2-0. And set up behind the plate is Kenny Jansen, as you see the rest of the umpiring crew there.
Hey, the book on Kenny Jansen, D-Rose, not a very big cutter, but he will give you that low pitch below the knees.
Yeah, and he's consistent. You're okay with that as an offensive player. He wants to give that pitch below the knees. If this pitcher can execute consistently, you better make the adjustment.
3-1. Swung on and missed. A full count now.
He was able to sneak that fastball by him on 3-1. So now we've got a battle on our hands.
A swing and miss. He struck him out.
Good strikeout
at the
end.
And with strike 3 recorded there, he's notched his first career major league strikeout.
Well, man, if he can become a consistent strikeout pitcher, you have to figure his career is going to end up being a solid one. All the best pitchers at this level have at least one pitch that they can go into in tough situations. So we'll see if he becomes one of those guys as his career goes along.
Into the box, Carson Kelly.
The catcher.
Just gets a piece of it, strike 1. Day off for him yesterday, but back out there for this one. windup and the 0-1.
He's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two. Oh, three of them for strikes. Two rotors.
And he misses there.
Carson Kelly, you have 0-2s. 1-2.
Into the windup and the pitch. Top of the third set to get underway. Striding forward, the designated hitter, Andy Young. And he starts the number 8 hitter with a strike, nothing and one. That misses wide. One ball and one strike. One and two now as that one's fouled off.
And played in Arizona, so I can hit.
Swing and a loop to the left. Trout ranging into the outfield. He can't get there as it falls in.
It's going to go in between.
Into the box now. Michael De La Cruz. He will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike. Getting on base. A big problem as you see the average there. One home run and a pair of RBIs. Margo's on the move. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning.
First one out.
Back to the top spot in the Arizona lineup now, and stepping in, Tim LoCastro. He singled first time up. Ball one to start the at bat. The 1-0.
Ball inside. Hey, always a good idea to take a couple of pitches when you're facing a young arm like this one. And now he's put himself in a real good hitter's count.
Two balls and a strike to count.
Battle back now the 2-1 pitch. One strike.
Will not catch the zone. Ball three.
Second one.
I love the approach out on the mound. Everything's down in the zone as it should be. But now you find yourself in a 3-1 count. You elevate a little bit more and get back in the zone.
He's going to swing. He's chasing on the zone.
Now at the plate, Christian Robinson. He's 0-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. 0-1 the count.
Same spot every time.
And that misses downstairs for a ball 1-1. Young, the runner at first with two gone. Didn't miss by much there, but it's just a bit high. Even count, two balls and two strikes.
Come on, yeah.
All set for the start of the fourth. And standing in the outfielder, David Peralta.
Yeah, not fooled by that breaking ball in his last AB at all. He jumped all over it. It's such a good feeling as a hitter when you know you're picking up the secondary stuff right out of the pitcher's hands.
A count of one ball, one strike to David Peralta.
To allow him to do the same thing here, so I think I actually hit it off.
Fooled with the curveball there, and it's strike two.
Got him to chase after the curveball below the zone there. That was a really nice pitch. That can be a really tough one to lay off of as a hitter.
Two balls and two strikes now. 2-2.
Full count, 3-2.
Full count now. Fastball. Low.
And he lays off there,
pitch
four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin stanza number four.
Oh, that's frustrating.
Digging in, the switch hitter, Ketel Marte. He's 0-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result as his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they can certainly roll too.
Pass through for a base hit, and he's 1-2 now.
There's a hard hit ground ball. Pitcher not able to get a glove on it. Hard single up in the middle. Watch your lips right there, Dan. Sent it back right where it came.
Nick Amon is in for the second time here as he looks at one outside. It's 1-0. Fouled away. Fouled off again, and now he's in a one and two hole. One run, four hits. No errors so far for the Diamondbacks.
Strikeout.
And this one's in the dirt. Throw to third. And he's crawled out on a
close
play occurred. That's a tough one right there. You're already in
scoring
position. So if you're a base runner in that situation, you've got to see it actually get away if you're going to try and take third.
Rounded up the first baseline.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch. Now he did well to get a piece that time, and it'll stay 2-2. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way, and he fouls this one off.
The
2-2 one more time. Bounce it to the left side. And there are two away now.
What a wild play there. Hold me toward third base. Shortstop from third right there. Honestly, if I would have thrown third right there, I probably could have got him out. I was like, got them spinning around. Nobody even moved out. We moved the camera down. I guess like that. It's pretty much the only way. It's not a very good one. You know, because right there, the feet are cut off. I'm just gonna try. See what's happening, but anyway. Nice. Spin through. Got him. Barely. Thumbnail shot there, and we're good to go.
First pitch of the AB on its way.
Nope.
A ball and no strikes.
Started off in a bit of a jam, and on third, and let's see
2-0 now.
If we can get out of
you
it.
You can see this guy's more focused at the plate right now. In that first AB, he went down on strikes.
Two balls and a strike.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed
stuff.
This guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
This is not...
And there's ball four as this one gets away a bit.
I just freaking walked another batter. I don't know. I feel like I'm just looking straight up.
And things are not looking good here in the fourth inning. That's the second walk of the frame. Good time for the catcher to watch the mound and have a chat with this guy to give him a little breather.
Carson Kelly is in two away now as he looks at a called strike one.
Another one. I don't know why I cannot
throw.
He's already walked two in this inning already. This guy just can't seem to find the strike zone.
Ball taken there. 2-1 now. Grounder down the line at third. Well, this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. 2-2. Here it is. Got it.
I'm gonna start to work out of it actually.
All so ready to go in the top of the fifth. Standing in is the DH, Andy Young. Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. Fastball just misses. That's ball one.
One ball, one strike.
Throw more strikes.
Get back up the middle. This will find its way into center field for a leadoff single.
Kind of three hits up the middle. This is what happens when you're throwing the ball.
So now to the plate, Michael De La Cruz. He'll take a breaking ball too low, and it's 1-0. Young aboard here at first with nobody out. And he lays off a fastball here that looked pretty good, but it's 2-0.
He may be down 2-0 after those first two pitches in this AB, but those are pitches he can feel pretty good about. They didn't miss by a whole lot, so it's not like he's all over the place.
And he's back standing.
Have the close calls.
The 2-1 takes a pitch for strike number two. first baseline.
Be a double play there. On to first, a double play. Double play.
So base is empty now after the double play. Next will be the speed threat, Tim LoCastro. This pitch is popped up. O'Keefe is under it. He handles it easily and the inning is over.
Back out there.
So stepping in is Christian Robinson. Thus far in this one. Wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch. Swing and a flare hit toward right. And that's in there. Base hit.
Give it up. In the first batter,
hey, sometimes that's how a rally gets started right there. I know it's a soft liner, but leadoff man on usually poses problems.
Got the ground ball to first base, man. Absolutely.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Ketel Marte. No one on base for him after the double play.
That two-ball really changed the complexion of this inning. It looked like the middle of the order was going to have a chance to get a big hit with some ducks on the pond, but now they just have to try and get a two-out rally started.
Behind 0-2 now. 3-6-3 to play. With the fifth and the sixth.
Nothing in two count.
Hopefully
we get
the strikeout here.
This one runs in on the
pitch that is nearly first.
Diamondbacks down without much of a fight, but they hold a 1-0 lead.
And one hit. And it's going to remain that way. The first start is going to end in a loss. Nice. So I'm not going to get a loss in my first game. And I need to see him. Alright, we got out of the jam there. Okay, we have to tie it up. Hit me. It did lose, but
well, they had to put in a couple of extra innings of work, but hey, listen, a win is a win, and any win is good, especially on the road.
A one-run game this afternoon, 3-2, the final finish. Joaquin Soria gets the win in relief, his second of the year. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vaskirchev. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
Six innings pitched, six hits, five strikeouts, two walks.
Time for the ball game. 2 hours and 53 minutes.
Anyway.
Thank you for joining us here this afternoon.
Part.
And we remind you to
be pitching daily. Thank you. Watching. See you next.